Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen of the internet, to WoW Leveling Undead Rogue Edition, episode 14, I think this is. Anyways, let's head through this portal, since we left it on that cliffhanger. Oh, what is this? We're inside of a little building? Okay. Got the Magister here, a couple Magisters here. To kill 20 of them. It's gonna take quite a while, I'd imagine. But I think we should be able to do it. Not too much issue. Let's see what else is around here. The minimap is not that useful. Since it's all black. Oh, there we go. Now that we've left the building. All kind of magisters, but Ambermill folks around here. The quest says Ambermill Mage slain, but there's like warders and more warders and brewmasters and stuff. I'm pretty sure those are not mages. Alright, well let's slice and dice some fools. Oh, that was one of the more grindy quests we've had to do in a while, just killing 20 guys. Transdimensional Warfare, Chapter 2. Excellent work. Now, eject them into our waiting hands. Alright. Savannah speaks directly through you. You must find the being responsible for keeping this dimensional pocket alive. Likely that fool, Eteric. Search the compound for him. Should you find him? Do what you must to stop him from channeling his magic. He is undoubtedly protected by a powerful arcane shield, and will send minions of arcane energy after you. Defeat the minions while they are near him to unleash their energies. No mage can handle that much power. Alright, I can do that. It was actually just over here by this Valkyr. Saw him while we were grinding out earlier. Here he is. Actually level 19, so he's not too far beneath us. But he's taken basically no damage from us, so I think we just have to wait for him to summon his minions. Or not? Thought he was gonna summon some minions that we had to pop near him. Kinda like a certain boss fight in this game. Cool. You're gonna resurrect all these nerds? Come on, raise. Yeah! Fantastic. A whole bunch of new magi for the Forsaken. I really like this horse. So majestic. Alright, Sylvanas, we've done as you asked. Actually, let's talk to Kralmarsh first.
Rooktar.
I only hope that we don't end up getting beat down by inconspicuous birds, cats, and trees next. Or seals. Could you imagine it? Ah, yes, for the Worgen Druid bear killing quest. Alright, Sylvanas.
What are we if not slaves to this torment?
Had I not witnessed what you did with my own eyes, I would not have believed it. Now, with the Ambermill Magi on our side, there is but one thing left to do before we retake Gilneas and send those Alliance dogs running for Stormwind. Sweet. On a cloak upgrade too. Very nice. The hour of victory approaches. Godfrey has devised a plan to decimate our enemies. I'm sending you into the field with him and his men to bring the rebel insurgents to their knees and seal the fate of the Alliance filth encroaching upon our lands. Our final march begins when you are ready. No, I'm ready. Let's throw this cloak on real quick. Alright, where do we need to go? Oh. All these guys actually have a couple quests for us. It's funny, and they're following us around. Alright, guys. So, this is Baron Ashbury. Our forces in Pyrewood were recently taken by way of sneak attack. The 7th Legion managed to infiltrate the town with their scouts, ultimately decimating our troops. The Dark Lady has tasked us with a rescue mission. We are to find survivors and get them out of Pyrewood safely. If any soldiers live there, or if any soldiers live, they are likely worthless, but we do as the Dark Lady commands. Let's get this nonsense over with. Pyrewood is directly southwest of the Forsaken Front. Alright. What about you, Mr. Godfrey? The attacks against our front are a distraction. With our attention turned towards the Worgen Onslaught, the Alliance has managed to take Pyrewood Village from our occupying forces. He hands us a bundle of torches. It must be purged. With these torches, we will burn Pyrewood Village to the ground, leaving only ashes for the enemy to hide behind. Let's not waste another minute. Pyrewood Village is located southwest of the Forsaken Front. Lead us there. Alright. We're gonna save some people, then burn the village. What else is he gonna have us do? Lord Walden. Our enemies are becoming smarter, adapting to our tactics. Recently, an attack was made upon, you guessed it, Pyrewood Village, southwest of here. Our troops occupying the town were decimated, of course, but what made the attack especially interesting was the radical composition of the attacking force. No humans were used. Rightfully, they fear being reanimated as Forsaken. Let us teach the non-humans a lesson in fear. Together, we will show them what happens to corpses that we cannot use. Alright. So we have to kill some guys, rescue some guys, and then burn some stuff. Sounds like a good plan to me. Well, look at what's going on over here. Well, this isn't what we need to do right now. Maybe we'll get a quest for this after we do our work in Pyrewood. Just lobbing barrels of poisonous gas at the Worgen. I like the sort of suspenseful music, too. Alright, where are the enemies at? Oh, they're stealthy. Okay, I see you. Oh, more 7th Legion stuff. I see how it is. I think that's actually kind of hurt. But fortunately, we also have 3 allies helping us. Alright, do we have to go inside? Oh, hold on. Go away, little night elf rogue thingy. Well, there we go. Okay. So this is the chapel. We just torched. Doesn't seem like much of a chapel, but I guess it works. Where are the troopers that we need to rescue? Oh, I see a friendly name over here. Yep. These stealthy enemies are really annoying. Gosh. And they're everywhere too, it's not like there's just here and there. We take like 3 steps and we get attacked again. Oh, stop. They're everywhere! Watch out! Yeah, I noticed. And what sucks is my stealth doesn't even help because my allies aren't stealthed, so my allies get attacked anyways. Oh, I see an enemy right here. He thought he could hide. Okay, let's burn this old mansion here. Oh, this is the town hall, never mind. I see some more scared troopers back here. We overheard their orders. No survivors. Wasn't there another one back here? Could have sworn I saw another green name. Pretty sure I couldn't see this far, but I'll take it. So from the shadows, we didn't stand a chance, and then he just kills him. Wow. Savage. Alright, well that's all the buildings burned. Let's finish killing off these guys and rescuing some nerds. And then we'll turn in all the quests at the same time. Oh my gosh, stop. Now, well, that looks like the last of the enemies and friendlies we need to save, so let's just talk to Godfrey first. The part of me that was Gilean died at Tempest Reach. Only vengeance remains. To that end, we have work to do. Spare me your pointless queries. Okay. What happened here today is between us. Say a word to anyone and you will find yourself in a corpse pit next to these poor fools. I suspect we'll see fewer humans at the battlefront. The risk for these cowards is too great. While destroying Pyrewood will certainly garner us an advantage over the Alliance upon the field of battle, our true purpose here is to leave them crippled. Southwest of here, near Greymane Wall, lies the 7th Legion base camp. We must search the base camp for battle plans. With the 7th Legion battle plans, we will be able to pinpoint an all-Alliance troop advancement in Silver Pine Forest. We got Shadow Step, which is a nice little ability that just lets us jump to a target. Can we use it on allies? Yes, we can. Nice. The Alliance reinforcements have established a foothold in the southwest region of Silver Pine, called the 7th Legion Base Camp. Our primary goal at the base camp is to sow discord among the troops. This is a lightning-fast assassination mission to kill their field commander, General Marstone. His death won't stop the Alliance advance, but it certainly will soften their ranks. Well, I guess it's a good thing we're specialized in assassination, although it literally doesn't matter. Doesn't actually make us any better at assassinating targets. See, it's just over here, it looks like. Just gonna let my allies kill that enemy that ambushed us. Quite frankly, I don't really care enough to kill him. Alright, so it looks like we just have to kill a bunch of enemies until it drops the item that we're looking for. Oh, here's General Marstone. Oh geez, that damage. Holy cow. Let's back off a bit. Let our stuff heal us. Jesus, that damage though. Okay. I'm not sure what we did wrong there. That seemed like entirely too much damage. Well, I mean, he is an elite, I guess. Actually, these are all elites, never mind. Alright, let's go ahead and body walk our way. I did not realize that those enemies were all elites, so we'll just have to choose our battles a bit better. Just take them on one at a time. Oh, Godfrey, back up. Actually, never mind. We might be able to kill this guy before Marstone gets too close. Yeah. Oh. The hitbox for clicking on these guys is so big. I just want to loot some bodies. Let's see if we can pull this guy out from the rest of the enemies. So what is that damage though, dude? He does like 80% of our damage in one hit. We don't have any like special items or anything. Okay, we just had to run until our allies took the aggro off of us. I don't want to do too much damage because, again, I don't want him to start targeting us again. Alright, we're good now. That was crazy. That's like one of the hardest... Well, not... It wasn't super hard. It was just a matter of... It wasn't hard mechanically. It was just hard numbers-wise. One of the hardest quests we've had to do so far. Oh, we got two of them this time. Let's back off while they're spinning so we don't take any damage. Still no battle plans yet. There we go. Okay, let's go to a safe spot so that if enemies respawn, we won't get instantly killed. Godfrey, what do you have for us? The rest of the Alliance fleet will arrive shortly, only to find their base camp decimated. Now for the second and most important part of our battle plan. Oh, okay, I guess we have to turn in both of them before he'll talk to us again. Search every filthy dwarven corpse. Yes, we did. He flips through the battle plan. Looks like reinforcement from the ships at Gilneas are marching soon. Crowley and Bloodfang have set up an encampment to the southeast for the Gilneas Liberation Front. Orno Crowley, daughter of Lord Darius Crowley, is currently at the Gilneas Liberation Front Camp, located near the Greymane Wall to the southeast. Our primary mission is to infiltrate the camp and capture her alive. The Dark Lady believes that she will be able to use Lorna as a bargaining chip against Crowley. I say we just kill her and bring her back as Forsaken, but we must do as the Dark Lady commands. We must hurry before the rest of the Alliance forces arrive. And we'll get a ring for it. A bit in this. So we have to waddle our way down to the Greymane Wall. Well, it won't be too bad with our mount. Appears there's the area we need to get to surrounded by elites, which is somewhat annoying. Maybe we can sneak around them though. Because I'd like to minimize combat if at all possible. At least unnecessary combat. Commander Lorna Crowley. So she is hostile, so I assume we'll just need to get her down to low health. Not attack that target? Oh, okay. So the Banshee Queen has sent assassins. Well, there we go. I was like, where did my friends go? What is that shield? Oh, it's the Lord of Run shield. Okay. Lorna, is that how you greet old friends? Godfrey? So the rumors are true. You would betray your kingdom out of spite. My kingdom? My kingdom is no more. Your father and Greymane saw to that. No, Gilneas died when they allowed murderous beasts to reign free, unchecked. Now lay down your arms and surrender. We are not here to kill you. Not yet. Ha! Huh, you'll have to kill me. Die! How rude. At least she's not almost one-shotting us, so that's a step in the right direction, though she is still hurting us pretty good. So we'll just have to kite her around a bit. Let our allies do damage to her. It feels so dumb doing this. But, you know, gotta do what you gotta do. Oh, come on, keep slowing her. I don't want to die. Pop my healing vial again. She's still after us, even though allies have probably done way more damage to her than I have at this point. There we go. Commander Lorna Crowley falls unconscious. Quickly, we must head back to the Forsaken Front before we are discovered. Okay. I'll get him heal us. Even though it's not actually really doing anything. Air of Mending. Heals for zero the next time you take damage. Wow, what a good healer. I assume that's bugged. That's probably why we've been having so much trouble, is because he's supposed to heal us, but he doesn't. He puts a shield on us sometimes, but his heals don't actually seem to do anything. Alright, back to the Forsaken Front. Alright, Sylvanas, we have returned with Miss Crowley.
I have no time for games.
You've done it! Finally, everything is in place. Should Crowley not accept our terms, his daughter will be turned. Alright. Our armies clash across the battlefield. Crowley and his forces are losing ground, and they do not yet know the fate of Lorna Crowley. We will meet with Crowley and his compatriots at midfield, and I will present them with terms of their surrender. They will either accept, or we will kill them all and leave their cities in dust. As my most trusted soldier, you were to stand by my side during the exchange. Tell me when you are prepared to leave. Let's go ahead and equip this ring. Get some free stats. We'll need to sell here in just a moment, too. Although for now, we will follow Sylvanas on her journey to midfield. Poor Chroma, just trying to run to keep up. No wings, no mount, just his legs huffing him across the battlefield. Lay down your arms and surrender. I will leave your cities in dust and your lives in ruin. Look at them. They scurry like rats, veering headlong into their doom. Surely Crowley and Bloodfang can see the futility in this. To the Greymane Wall, we will force their hand. I'm pretty sure this music theme is Sylvanas' Lament as well. Yeah, Song of Sylvanas. It's one of my favorite themes in Warcraft. Crowley, your forces have fallen before my mighty army. You have lost. Well, here he comes, Darius Crowley. And pack leader Ivar Bloodfang.
It's not over, Sylvanas. Not yet.
You frivolously throw away the lives of your people while your own king sits atop his throne of lies, nary lifting a finger to help. Is Gilneas worth the lives that have been lost? The lives that will be lost? You cannot win.
We will die trying.
And her daughter? You could have saved her. You could have offered her your blood, yet you did not. Why?
Lorna? What? Where is she? What have you done to her?
Nothing. Yet. I now present you with a choice that I was never given. I offer you the life of Lorna for your unconditional surrender. Choose your next words wisely, Crowley. Deny me, and she will serve me in undeath. Forever.
Bring her, Godfrey!
Ah, oh, there they are.
Godfrey, you deceitful maggot!
Hello, old friend.
Lorna, release her. I will sound the retreat. You can't be serious, Crowley, you miserable bastard.
Release her, Godfrey.
Of course, mistress.
Now leave here, Crowley, and never return.
Lordaeron belongs to the Forsaken.
Forgive me, daughter.
She just takes off.
Soldiers of the Horde, we are victorious! Lordaeron is...
Lady Sylvanas Windrunner dies.
What have you done, Godfrey? Something that should have been done a long time ago, you filthy animal. Aeneas belongs to me, and so will the rest of Lordaeron! Now join your mistress in death!
Oh jeez. That's rather rude. Oh, we can't actually fight them. Okay. Oh, now we can. I don't know why they don't have health bars, but... More bugs I'm imagining. So that means I also can't see how many... Actually, never mind, I can see combo points on my little, my unit frame. Oh, Okay, they leave.
Fix her! Fix her!
We are bound to her, sisters. It will destroy us, sister. It is our sacred duty. The pact was made, the bargain made. Or the pact was sealed, the bargain made. Then let it be done. I was gonna say, there's no way she actually dies, because she's currently the leader of the Horde, so... And she's back. I saw only darkness. So that's like, what, like the third time she's died? Come back? As I drifted towards nothingness, a brilliant light appeared, and then another. And another, my dear Valkyr. I know now, beyond a shadow of a doubt, that the Valkyr are our future. We will never stop fighting for Lordaeron. Never.
We are the Forsaken. We will
Lady Sylvanas Windrunner grimaces in pain.
In our way.
This is not over. Godfrey and his traitorous allies will pay for what they've done, as will the remaining Alliance forces occupying Lordaeron. Our work has only just begun. Give us that belt. This war has taken its toll on us as a people. We have lost much to secure our place as the rightful rulers of Lordaeron. And though the moment is won, the battle continues to rage in other parts of the Eastern Kingdoms. I must return to the Undercity to recuperate. I want you to go to the Hillsbrad foothills in my stead. As my most trusted soldier, you will lead our forces to absolute domination against our enemies in Hillsbrad. Report to High Executor Darthalia at South Point Blockade to the east. Alright. Well, that's all the quests for Silver Pine Forest, it looks like. Every single one of them. At least for the Horde. I don't think the Alliance have any. I'm pretty sure it's a Horde-only zone. But, yeah. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.